Why is this fence split in half and spaced 16 feet apart? And what is the story behind these blue posts that go into that red building further ahead? Hello, I am Anand Rane and I welcome to my vlog Locations, Travels and Stories. So continuing with the mini series Where is San Andreas Fault? So today we'll explore locations north of San Francisco. So I would like to begin today's episode at the Bear Valley Visitor Center here. As you can see, it's the main visitor center in the Point Reyes National Seashore area. And it has a lot of information regarding trails around here, all the region, all the wildlife and also on the earthquakes. So the title of today's episode is A Land Torn Apart. And the best place to witness it is the earthquake trail here. It's near the Bear Valley Visitor Center. It's a very small and informative trail that everyone can visit. So let's go and explore the trail. So as I said in the first episode of my vlog, the West Marine Anomaly. So here is an aerial photo of the San Andreas Fault. So if you can see, here is the San Andreas Fault going here. So this is the North American plate where you see the hills are very much plain and there are small oak trees going. They're growing spread apart here, and if you go to the right, all this land is covered with dense trees, so that forms the part of Pacific plate. So this is the aerial view of the West Marine Anomaly that I was talking about in the first episode. So this is a nice information board that shows the movement of Point Reyes Peninsula from Southern California to the north. As I said in the first episode, the West Marine Anomaly. So if you see the first picture here, about 20 million years ago, the Point Reyes Peninsula was near Los Angeles. About 11 million years ago, the Point Reyes Peninsula shifted further north and it lied between San Francisco and Los Angeles. So today, the Point Reyes Peninsula has crossed San Francisco and it lies northwest of San Francisco about 40-45 miles that we visit right now. And about 10 million years from now, the Point Reyes Peninsula will travel further ahead in on its northwestern journey. So walking on the earthquake trail, we pass the nice bridge here and a small stream beneath it. So I'll just record some natural sounds here. So this is a nice world map that shows tectonic plates on the surface of Earth. So here you can see this is the North American plate, this is the Pacific plate, and if you go further here in California, you'll see the boundary between the two plates, and this is the San Andreas Fault that we are looking in these vlog episodes. This is an illustration that shows the journey of San Andreas Fault from Southern California. So this is Southern California here, and fault goes all the way on the western edge of California, passes through San Francisco and goes up north here. And further ahead, this is illustration of how the fault looks. So you can, here you can see the two plates moving. So one goes up or north, other goes south here. And because of this movement, this is the lateral strike slip movement of the fault. And in places you can see these creeks and streams, they are bent out of the normal path because of the movement of the fault. So walking on the earthquake trail here, we come to the main exhibit on this trail, which is the split fence. So if you can see here, this is the one part of the fence behind me, and other part of the fence is back there. So these two parts of the fence, they are split 16 feet apart. And the reason behind this split in the fence is that the main trace of San Andreas Fault passes directly between these fences. So this is an old photo taken just after 1906 earthquake, and you can see some buildings in the background, and there's a picture of a woman standing here, and in between you can see this trace. This is a trace of the San Andreas Fault and the land that was torn apart during that earthquake. So that trace is visible today, and it is marked with this blue post. Now the torn part of the land, it is healed by over the time by the natural elements, rain and soil over here, but you can still see the active trace of the fault and goes directly into that red building over there. That red building is called Red One Classroom. So here is some information regarding the active trace of the fault. So let's head up the stairs and be in the active trace of the San Andreas Fault. So here is some information about the great earthquake that happened in San Francisco on April 18, 1906. It was a major earthquake that hit the city till now. And here is information of another earthquake that happened in 1989, also on the San Andreas Fault. So the epicenter of this fault was located in the south, and from here, if you see here, you can see the San Andreas Fault right through the Bay Area. So this is another actual photo of the fence being split apart during 1906 earthquake. You can see that displacement here, and this part was on the North American plate. This was a part was on the Pacific plate. You can see the trace of San Andreas Fault between the fences, and it is split apart during that earthquake. And here you can see the geologist looking for the actual trace of the San Andreas Fault beneath the soil. And this is an ancient equipment used to determine earthquakes. And finally, this is the map of all the fault systems that are present in Bay Area. You can see there are a lot of faults here, The main one, as I said, was the San Andreas. Then you have the Hayward Fault over here and the Rogers Creek Fault on the north. And you can see. And the interesting thing here is all these faults are oriented in southeast to northwest direction. And also all the hills here in Bay Area, hills and ridges in the Bay Area, they are also oriented in southeast to northwest direction. So these hills over here, they are formed due to movement of the lands and earthquakes and the fault in this region. So traveling in the northwestern direction from here, the San Andreas Fault alternates between land and ocean until it reaches a town of Point Arena, which is about 100 miles from here. From there, it leaves the land for good and travels all the way through the ocean. So the San Andreas Fault ends at a point called as Mendocino Triple Junction, where it meets another fault. It's called Juan de Fuca Fault, and that fault is located in the north along the border of Oregon and Washington states. So that fault forms a subduction zone up in the north, and it gives rise to the large volcanoes in the Cascade regions in the Pacific Northwest. So I would like to conclude this episode and the mini-series here at the Bear Valley Visitor Center in Point Reyes National Seashore. I hope you enjoyed the journey of San Andreas Fault through the Bay Area. And if you like the episode and the mini-series, please subscribe to the channel. And till then, see you and have a great time. Thank you. And thanks for watching.